as a child, I read a lot. You know, so reading, knowing what was happening in other parts of the world, how great leaders were transforming corporate America and other places, excited me so much. So I grew up with this mindset that what these guys do it, I will do it the same. And so that drove the whole idea of turnaround. It's exciting when we talk about turnaround, when we have the opportunity to turn around business and we do it well, we turn around business, we create value for shareholders and for stakeholders in fact. So
that need to read as young people. Autobiography is better, but if you can't, whatever you read. To
I really like to do things differently, to challenge status quo, to do the unorthodox. 34 years when the journey started, and we worked extremely hard, we made sacrifice to succeed, and it was quite rewarding.
Beneficiary, I have never done government contract on my life, and I've never had government waiver anything. I work hard and I make my money hard.
But I like to say that growing up, a couple of things affected and influenced who I became in life, okay, what I became. One was what my dad always told us when we were growing up, that if you earn a dollar and you don't save anything, if you earn $1 billion, you won't save anything. And so that discipline of investment, keeping something, don't consume everything you get, actually helped me significantly. So philosophy of savings, deferred consumption, philosophy of making long-term investment.
A business, an entrepreneur must, I wouldn't say situational, but it must be quick and fast in your ideas and be able to add very quick and be able to add very quickly. Know when an opportunity presents itself and don't fail to seize the opportunity. They say that success to a large extent is dependent on being at the right place at the right time.
I don't know of many people who have succeeded in life that are not disciplined. You must have a rigorous way to doing things. You must know that you must make sacrifices. You must be disciplined. And you must stay focused on what you're doing.
They need to invest long-term. Invest long-term in this sector, in this case, financial sector, which is very strategic for the continent, because we try to democratize banking, we try to create access to banking facilities, we try to facilitate payment, we support the SMEs. So we realize that this investment that was driven by long-term vision actually has been able to create a lot, not just for us, but also for the community where we've done business, for individuals in the ecosystem. And that led to the philosophy of agriculture. And just summarizing or just defining the concept is, you know, first the realization that the private sector in Africa has a role to play in the development of Africa, which again speaks to what you're doing, the theme of the session. And two, that the private sector in Africa must invest in key sectors of the African economy that have the ability to create both economic prosperity and social wealth. So you take any business, you know, just to think long-term investment, key sectors, power, infrastructure, energy, areas that can create economic return for the shareholders as well as create social wealth. So to me, I see this as an African solution to Africa's challenge.
When you dream dreams, you have to work hard to actualize the dreams. And that's the difference between a successful person and one that's not successful. Some have read more books than some others. But those who decide from reading, not just for entertaining yourself, but reading to adopt or shape a pattern for your future, and realizing also that even if you've read and agreed this is what you want to do, the most important element is ability to translate that idea to reality, and that is what is important. So to everyone, I'm saying, let us decide who we want to be, what we want to be, and let's work hard. 99% of it is the hard work that we put into making it a reality.
Key reasons why I made it in business is because early in my career in Nigeria, I benefited from the mentorship of one man, Chief Ebitimi Banigo, at Allsafe Trust Bank. It helped me to develop my strategic thinking and insights and to channel my ideas into concrete actions so that when the opportune moment arrived at the age of 34, I had the self-belief to gather a small group together to take over and revive a failing bank through innovations in our services. And there was a lady to
advise on role models, and three, say to yourself, if this role model achieved this, I can even do better. And
when we think about a champion, we often think about an individual who is a winner. A champion who embodies true greatness is one who carries the fight, refuses to settle for a comfortable existence, thinks about the plight of others, inspires hope, and decides to make the aspirations of others their personal fight, despite major challenges. That is the difference between being a winner and a champion.